take the pilgrims and put them on the ship before the ebb.
Where are you going?
To explain the plans.
I don't want you to tell them the plans. Besides, you're not coming.
What?
Brace, you have always been my father's man in my father's world. We're headed to my mother's now.
James, tell me this too is mercy. I'm an old man, I would never survive. Tell me that's the reason.
Brace, you were not born for freedom. You wouldn't know what to do with it. It would torture you. Now go home. Everything belongs to you now.
The soldiers are here!
James Delaney. Well, look at you.
James.
No. Explain this. I have the very same mark on me. And when I was taken prisoner in Africa,
what is it?
You tell me. You don't speak, but you do have answers. You do. And you will give me answers.
My father's debts amounted to a sum total of £215.17. Behold, £215.17. Mr. Thoit will pay each one of you exactly what you are due, but you will form an orderly line. You will form an orderly line. Carlsbad will know my name and know my business.
I'm afraid you've used the wrong words. Get out.
Do you treat sickness of the mind, Doctor?
Just keep walking.
And you have pledged to give us the names of the Americans who conspired with you and others unnamed to commit acts of treason within the confines of the City of London.
Mayte awana oya mini padua ka
Mr. Delaney.
Na nebubo.
Mr. Delaney, unless you give up the names of your co-conspirators, every single stitch that they have just put into your flesh, I will pull out myself with my fingernails. Give us the names, or you will be racked! I will squash your balls myself and make you eat the paste. You promised to give me those names.
Did I? I must have lied. Atticus, you stole my horse and you left your name. So, what do you want?
Well, 15 pounds.
15 pounds.
And the return of your ropes.
I will give you 15 pounds, minus the heels on my boots. And I will need your eyes and ears from now on as well.
Nucco was my mother's tribe.
No, no, James. Your mother came from Naples.
He bought some land. And he bought a wife. And he bought them both for gunpowder.
He told me never to speak to you of buying her.
Yet he told me everything.
When?
When he lit his fires on the foreshore.
Nothing you could tell me about that man would surprise me. He was half human at the end, and he would squat right here and make deals with ghosts in the flames. And he would speak in a language that was like ravens fighting.